Bruv, you're a soup. Why are you going to go watch normal
no,
people?
No, but the issue is, they're his boys, bruv. That's like me watching porn with you in it. Exactly! That's mad!
We are live.
We are live.
We are live.
Did I say welcome to the main event?
Run that thing, Brandon. Are you mad?
Oh, man.
Behave before you talk about what I'm talking about, yeah?
Disclaimer! Run that thing back. No, man, stay there in your corner, man. Run that thing back, fam. I don't want to hear nothing from you. We are live, guys. I'm Joe, one further to Cyber Nerds.
Revenue GS.
So I'm Mr. Blitz Tech.
And today we've got Season 2, Episode 7 of The Boys Review. Butcher Baker, Candlestick Maker. Now, if you haven't already, head over to the subscribe button and subscribe to the channel. The penultimate episode of Season 2. Sam, where do you want to start?
I say we start at the beginning, innit? Because this intro, for me, says a lot about a lot. So obviously it just shows a guy who's working with Stormfront, or the propaganda that she's trying to...
He's working with Stormfront.
Is he not making the memes?
Nah.
Was he going through the memes?
I feel like the guy at the beginning is a regular Joe Blow. Cool.
That's even better. Then.
Yeah, that's regular Joe Blow.
Cool. So he was going through the memes, seeing on the news Stormfront, going about his day, and he comes across a soup.
No, he doesn't.
Is that just normal person? That's even
worse. What was you watching, bruv?
Okay. Bruv. Either way, yeah. Okay, he comes across a normal person, and because of the stuff he's been...
exposed to, yeah. The propaganda he's
been consuming, exactly. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Guys is like, are you just one of them? And he's like, no, I'm just a normal guy, I've got a family, man don't care, shoots in the face. And obviously, if you relate it to the real world, with just people who come to the country, whether it be government or whatever have you.
Sam. But if you're going to take it here, fam.
It's the truth.
No, bro. I know it's the truth, but I'm saying if you're going to take it here, I don't know what you need. Like, you've got permission to speak freely. Uh-huh. You're talking in codes and... say what you got to say.
I just forgot most of the words, but I just like how they're relating that to, especially England, where there are foreigners coming into the country, whether it be through illegal or illegal means, and it's just... what the government say to people, and they just consume that and be like, oh, that must be, it must be wrong.
Let me help you out. In other words, yeah, we're having Brexit because of stuff like this. Boom. There you go. You're welcome.
I'm not even going to get to that.
Bro, you're over here. That man got time for that, bro. Not this channel. Say it like it is, bro.
You know what I'm saying? People just spew stuff on the news, and they just take it how they want. And because they're watching a certain person... like you're saying, oh, it's the SWJs saying, oh, yeah, we should let people into the country, whether they be super terrorists or whatever have yous. Well, you don't know how that person came into the country, and you don't know how that person is benefiting the country, yet you're just seeing something, seeing that they must be doing wrong, family or not, they must be dead, or they must be exed, whether they be removed from the country or moved from life. For me, that intro just was like, raw.
That's one of the... probably the peakest intros we've had here.
Yeah.
Because it's like, there's like barely any dialogue to it. It's so like, when I talk about dialogue, it's from on his behalf, all you see is him feeding. You know what I'm saying? Like from time he wakes up to the time he goes back to sleep, that's all man's getting, innit? And like, and that's what media really does, innit? So... it is what it is. So,
yeah.
peak.
It began already. It was mad.
Nah. I don't really know to jump into, because like, I feel like both of you, man, took it to like certain scenarios. But I just feel like what happened in there is everything. Do you know what I'm saying? It's the result of hate crime. It's the result of this. It's the result of that. Like, just the reason for bare these things. But also... I feel like we're getting deeper to Stormfront's actual agenda. Mm-hmm. Now, obviously, Stormfront's like, oh, you don't need the whole country. You just need a certain amount of men who are ready to roll out with you when the time comes. Now, in that scenario, when you're building a militia like that, you get those people like this brother who aren't waiting for the call to action.
Mm.
They believe the call to action's already come,
mm-hmm.
and they're taking that stuff into their own hands. Now, that's the thing that's going to be peak for me. Because obviously, let's say brother gets apprehended, yeah? Do you think Stormfront's not meeting my man? Like, you're a prime candidate for the V.
Mm-hmm.
Now, she's a bro. Halfway through the episode, she's we need more V. We need more soups. Exactly. What kind of soups do you think she's trying to bring
right,
through?
Exactly.
This brother. Yeah, do you get what I'm saying?
That's it.
So,
not scared.
Bro, she's not looking for the ones who were just coming to the rallies, bro.
Mm.
She's looking for that. That's who is she's recruiting, bro.
Mm.
Them man there. Mm-hmm. So I feel like the thing is, cause next episode is just one episode. I'm struggling to believe that they can wrap up all of this.
Hell no.
In one. Do you know what I'm saying? And this is where it hurts me.
Don't say hell no, because if they end up rushing everything into one episode.
No. That's not what I'm saying.
Saying. Sam said hell no.
I mean, for them to do that would be
a... Unless they're going to give us like a whole hour and 20 minutes.
No, that's not enough. Unless episode 8 is a movie, a legit movie, it ain't got enough to wrap up all of the threads we got going right now. Because so much stuff's been happening through the season.
Mm.
And that's what I was going to get to, bruv. I just... 8 episodes, fam. You, listen, just give man the 12 episodes, bro. Like, I don't know how we went from, like, 24 to 15 to 12 to, like, 8. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, soon we're going to be having, like, 4 episode seasons and that, bruv. Like, man needs the full 12, COVID or not.
Well, it's the rule of less is more, innit?
Nah, it's not. It's not, bruv. You got to tell...
There's no fillers, no night. Man just keeps getting slapped up.
Yeah, but in 12 episodes, I don't think there'll be filler, bruv. I feel like there's certain aspects that we could expand on just a little bit more, bruv. Do you know what I'm saying? But yeah, that whole thing was mad.
Mm.
That whole thing was mad. Really, what stood out for you in the episode?
Besides that, obviously, the whole propaganda. Alright, so let's touch on Stormfront, Homelander, and the Utes.
I think this whole part...
I think that's kind of going to backfire at some point. Because the way there is no explanation to... Obviously, you see it from the beginning, what those two were doing. And the mom was feeling it. I just didn't expect them to do it right away. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, that was just too quick for me.
For me, it wasn't too quick at all because, bruv...
Bruv, it's first time.
It doesn't matter. It don't matter because, firstly, the kid's already been exposed to Homelander, yeah?
Yeah.
Like,
but last time, he was pissed
at him. It don't matter. But the reason it don't matter is because the kid has been lied to for a long time. So then, it doesn't take a lot to get him to switch buttons. Bro, you got to bear in mind, he's a child.
Yes.
And what was Stormfront came at, man, with the, do you like any things that kids actually like? Then, when they pose the things that kids like, mum's like, no. So the second the mum's gone away... It's like boom, boom, boom. So, and you got to think about the reaction. Think about the reaction the kid had to Homelander. Instant rage, instant boom. Right. And now, it's done the same thing to mum. So,
because I thought that, you know everything you just said?
Yeah.
I thought there was just seeds being planted. We go away, and now you start seeing the kid rebel. That's what I thought.
No, because in that scenario,
I see what these lot are doing. They're just planting. Because even he said, oh, before the scene cut, he goes, oh, You'll see us more often.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I'm saying? So I thought, oh, cut scene. I thought, oh, these men are gone.
Nah.
And then now you're going to start seeing the kid rebel. But two's, now you're back. They're still in the same place.
When man said, oh, we'll be seeing more often, I knew this is happening now.
Mm.
It's the same part in all movies. As soon as they start making plans for the future, not happening, bruv.
Mm.
Not happening. So as soon as that happens, but what they have set up is, the way the kid bust out with them, it just only guarantees he's not staying with them.
Yeah, because I was going to say his moral compass is not going
to exactly. That's what's going to happen.
That
exactly.
And he has me brought up like that.
That's
when he sees
bang,
them
bang,
two,
bang, bang.
That's
what
the backfired. Like,
no, bang. Yeah. Yeah, but see, that's why I just think it didn't happen too fast because you can already tell this kid's spending, he's going to have a week of fun. watching Homeland, the movies, experiencing the world, and then they're going to cross the line and it's going to be the kids that's like, nah.
Yeah.
And you, man, have already taught me how to use all my powers that's now.
Yeah, he's ready.
That's that. He's gone through his moral compass training. He's about to go through his superhero training.
Mm.
And then he's going to decide who he wants to be. Like,
exactly.
Do you know what I'm saying? And I feel like, obviously, I really want this kid to be more of a season three thing.
Mm.
But, I mean, there's high potential for this youth to get murked. There's high potential for the youth to get murked, fam. Because if this youth gets murked, yeah, that could be the Stormfront Homelander thing. Do you know what I'm saying? Because Stormfront, bruv, we've never really deep Stormfront's mind on her real plan,
mm-hmm.
besides the propaganda stuff. Mm. But obviously that could be propaganda to us. She could already know that Homelander's done out. And what was her line? You're the first natural born super. Her actual plan could be the U and not Homelander, but she needs Homelander to get the U.
Mm.
Do you know what I'm saying? So you see where it becomes like the kid can decide the fate of a lot of stuff. So
I think if he stays alive, then he's the second coming. So I think he has to go.
You think he's the second coming of Homelander?
Yeah, like I think if he stays, then he's just you know what I'm saying? He'll beat Homelander,
mm.
and that kind of defeats the whole thing of this thing. So I think he's gonna die,
bro.
I just don't see him being here unless he's a go on.
Mm. See,
if he's a go-on, then I'm like, all right, cool.
Nah, the thing is,
because the traits are there, innit? The mom intervenes a lot. You see what Kiki was doing to me.
Yeah.
Boom. Sorry, this is Dragon Ball talk, innit? If you don't get it, then maybe you should go watch Dragon Ball.
I see that as well. But I feel like, bruv, there's potential for them both to survive, fam. Like, yeah, if they come together and have a Goku Gohan Cell moment where they both use their powers to vanquish Stormfront, but then, yeah, bro,
this is not Clark Kent.
No. See, I don't think it is, bro. But if that can happen, but then the kid still cuts from Homelander.
Yeah, exactly.
That, do you know what I'm saying? Like, there's dynamics here that can work in bare ways, and this is what I love about that whole scenario, fam. Yeah. I don't know, what stood out for me, yeah, I don't like talking about these, man, and I'm not really, but they touch on, you know what I'm saying, the brother we had on watch, Black Noir.
Mm.
All right, it's confirmed in this episode Black Noir is actually a black character.
Mm-hmm.
All right, cool. But I feel like that was obvious because all black characters' names start with black, do you know what I'm saying? So, get me? Wow. So, I know people were like, oh, we don't know, but, nah, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? Get me? So, the thing what's mad is... obviously, he's not dead.
No, I hope he isn't, because if they put him out like that...
The thing is, what's sick about that is...
Man dies of allergy.
Exactly.
Because he's so super.
Because it's the boys, that something like that would make sense.
Mm.
Because it's Black Noir, and on the low, we love him. Mm. Do you know what I'm saying? It'd be peak if it happened like that. Do you get what I'm saying?
Bro, that's the worst way.
Bruv.
Like, any
but
suit.
But even what he means.
The history of suits, whether good or bad.
Kryptonite to peanuts.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that is my, what, your thing is nuts. Mad. Yeah.
The thing is, I just thought it was mad. Not the way man showed up, but, like, I feel like we just haven't really tapped into, I'm going to keep saying it. We ain't tapped into Black Noir enough, bruv.
Exactly.
Because, like, he was having Stormfront up, fam.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
yeah, but
differently.
I think it's not hard for someone to have her up. I've never seen her, like,
bruv,
combat abilities.
She lit up
just powers.
And Homelander chilled, bruv. Like, that happened, bruv. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, her power. I feel like her power level, Stormfront power level, is here. But the difference is, like, mentality.
Mm.
Like, do you know what I'm saying? Like, Starlight's not really on smoke. So you know what I'm saying? So I feel like Stormfront would have a rap because of that. But I didn't expect Black Noir to have her rap like that. Yeah, hand-to-hand combat, but bruv, like, she had no chance, bruv. She couldn't even get a flare off,
yeah,
bruv.
Like,
we've never seen her, like, do any hand combat experience. How many missions has she
done? I don't think she can beat, man. I don't think anyone could beat him hand-to-hand combat like Batman. She didn't... Like,
so you would expect
her to...
Obviously, she's not going to to give her a chance because to use electricity saying, against him.
I was about to say, because they've been saying this whole thing.
Neutralize her real quick.
Yeah, her power is just electricity. She's, that's it. Nah, she's a Nova.
There was electricity in the room. And that's the there was electricity in the room.
And she couldn't even tap into her team. Yeah.
Neutralized
her real quick. Dazed her so quickly. Yeah, so.
I thought that was mad. Obviously, Maeve's gone off the deep end. But has she? Not really. Like, she's gone through a whole thing. And it was mad.
I think she's dead, though.
No, she's 100% dead. She's dead, bro.
Her plan.
Bro, she's dead. She's dead. Maeve is off. Bro, I wouldn't be surprised. First 5 minutes of episode 8, Maeve's gone. Mm. Boom. Quickly. Like, bro, what is the point? What? Did someone think there's going to be a happy reunion with her and her girl?
Yeah.
Nah. You know, she needs to be out of it.
You know what's interesting with her, yeah? As soon as her partner left.
She's getting langed by the mandem.
I was like, wait, what? Like, not just one, two of them. One of them was a brother. I was like, is there a message to this? Because you know these men don't do anything just to do it.
I feel like there was bare messages, innit?
But I thought that whole thing was mad, just having that.
Yeah, I didn't think it was mad at all, bruv, because it's like, bruv, we always see the other side of these men.
Mm.
And, like, yeah, Maeve might be in a lesbian relationship, but I swear earlier on that she said she was actually bi, and it was like, oh, that doesn't sell.
Yeah, she was with her before.
Yeah, she already said that.
Then maybe they said that in another episode.
So, okay, then I didn't Yeah, they said, that. Oh, like, okay. When it was doing, like, the art of it, and she was like, oh, I'm actually bi, and she was like, oh no, that don't matter. This is what sells, and we're gonna push this narrative. So when that happened, I was just like, "Oh, that's normal, bro." The thing that was more funny to me is that they're in bed. Obviously, she's got the superpowers in the scenario. Yeah. Both of these men are conked to sleep, bro, and she's up like eating like smoking a thing. Like, I just finished these brothers. Do you know what I'm saying?
That's a good nut, right,
bro? I was like, "Hey,
that's probably why she did."
That's the whole thing. Exactly, that's the whole thing. That's why I was like, "Hey, that seems kind of like that." For me, that was Meg's best scene. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, hey, that's full domination right there, fam. Where's the third brother? Third brother might have been in the bathroom or something.
Boy.
Get me? But yeah, interesting dynamic with, what's her name? Ashley coming in as well, Maeve getting on be a human. I understand it, but I don't like it because it's like, Ashley now has a moral compass, meaning she could press a decision could come down to Ashley and we now don't know what side she's going to fall on because everything else has been Vaughn, the mission, the job. But Maeve just hitting her with that one line, be a human. Imagine if Maeve's life's on the line and she could save it.
That's a Martha.
See?
That's a Martha.
Yeah. Do you know what I'm saying? No, bruv, they put that in there, fam. Mm. Do you know what I'm saying? So it's mad, bruv. Like, so many things that, cool. I want to jump to, anyone got anything for candlesticks? I mean, lamplighter. My bad.
Just a fun scene with him, bruv. Like,
what, the porn thing?
Yeah, bruv. That thing is
that it was mad, but
it's mad. No, because you know why? Because you never think of these things.
Like, no, even you do, though, bro.
Like, you know what? All this time that we've been watching this and it's pure crud, I never thought of like, raw. There's actually someone out there profiting by making adult movies based on these characters.
There ain't Batman porn or something, bro?
Bruv, I don't know. I never come across one. Sam, is there one?
I'm guessing so.
There's gotta be, bro. There's gotta be all of that. Saying, like, man, all of that's gotta be out there.
Bro, I've never come across anything, so I never thought about it. So when I'm seeing here, I'm like, it's funny. It's funny. Do you know
to
what I'm
me,
saying?
The like, funny part of it
plus,
is that Lamplighter, a soup himself, is watching it.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
That was the weird dynamic to me.
Bro, you're a soup. Why are you gonna go watch normal people?
No, but the issue is, they're his boys, bro. That's like me watching porn with you in it. Exactly! That's mad! That's mad, bro!
They're all mad,
but I didn't get that because I was like, bro, you was in the 7, you and Homelander were sitting around a table, now you're watching a brother dress up like Homelander, Lengating in front of her human husband.
Something happened then.
See, now I'm starting to think, maybe if I would have put it past Homelander, the Homelander's been lenging his girl, or was laying Lamplighter's girl at the time, and that's why he was. That's why they was talking about cuckolding bears in an episode.
Exactly.
Like, yeah, Homelander's been doing this to us. Like that. See now, and if he was traumatized off that, I can understand why it's just he's going like, you know, that's what he was watching.
Man's going to study, like,
bro.
Oh,
no, it's not the study. He was gassing himself up off that to build up for the suicide.
Exactly.
Think about the one. imagine there's a traumatic moment in your life that happens, and then someone has made that into a movie and profited off of it. You would never watch that.
Mm.
But the guy, that's all he's consuming 2 hours before he sets himself on fire in front of a statue of Homelander and the Seven. That, bro, that just makes sense.
They removed me.
Yeah. I'm not even hearing that. But, bro, he was going to murk himself. He wanted to do it in front of his statue of himself. Mm. Like on a masturbation tip. Like. But they already took that, bro. He's done out, bro. Like, I thought that character was good an episode ago.
Yeah.
But when I say they finished, bro.
Finished.
In two scenes, they finished him, boy.
Ashes.
Finished him, bruv. But yeah, man. So I wanted to... I didn't want to touch on that. You took it to the porn thing. But I wanted to talk about just him killing himself. I thought that was mad.
It was.
But then... Who's blowing up these heads, bro?
It must be Cindy.
Cindy.
I was thinking, like, who else can it be? Because... Like, they've obviously now they've illustrated her power, and then they alluded to it at the beginning of the season.
Bruv, so where was Cindy? Okay. Cindy's the one that escaped from the mental asylum.
Right.
Okay.
But she was at the mental asylum when
someone helped her go. When someone's heads got blown up.
That's what I'm saying. So you're saying that at the beginning, I'm guessing Lamplighter was like, do this mission, and then take her back. But is she then too powerful to be like, under a leash like that?
Bruv, how did Lamplighter have Cindy on a leash, take her to where their man were meeting, blow up that chick's head, and then Lamplighter come to meet them and be working with that unit? Don't make sense.
Because even then, like, when they met in the thing, and then she goes like, oh, hey, Cindy, he was mad shook of her.
Have you seen her?
And then she was like, oh, you must be one of these guys' friends. So yeah. They've obviously had...
Nah, she's talking about the orderlies, bruv. Because they was wearing orderly outfits, she's like, you're one of these lot's friends. I don't like liars, bruv.
Mm.
I don't know. The thing is...
To me...
Like, who else can it be that is shown like that?
I think that after watching that, I was like, I'm going to go back to the episode where the FBI lady...
Gets her head blown up.
I'm going to see who's every there. Single person that's there.
Mm.
Then check every single person in that room, bro.
Because
There is no way. Because at first we thought, oh, maybe she got something implanted. If she mentions Vaughn, boom, goes off.
Mm.
But, bro, there were like innocent people just there for the trial getting finished left, right and centre.
Mm. I don't know.
So,
I don't think there was
purposely...
I don't think it was innocent people.
But
there was bad people running,
but
we don't know individual people's involvement. I thought it was targeted, bro.
Maybe. If it
was targeted, then you would have got the Congress.
No, because you don't know who's running it, bro. Mm. If I'm the Congress lady and I'm trying to get Supes banned or whatever, this is a perfect moment.
This is a perfect moment.
That's right, Emmanuel, BVS.
It might be the Congress lady herself.
Mm.
Blowing their heads up, then acting traumatized.
Winking about, we need to trust each other and all that.
Yeah, fam.
Bro, like, who is it? Catwoman in
Batman. Yeah, Batman, bro.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, shoot up bear man. Screaming for help, bro.
You know what I'm saying? Bro, like, I just have, because that is so peak of what's going on. And that person is right there.
Mm-hmm.
That person's been with us this whole time. Imagine saying, clocked it, bro.
See, and then that's the thing. I feel like it would be gangster if it was someone that we knew.
Mm.
But at the same time, I'm just like, we ain't seen Los Pollos in ages. Times,
exactly.
What's this brother been doing? Do you know what I'm saying? I'm not saying it's him.
He sees everything.
But I'm saying he's about. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, it's actually going to be mad. Like, I cannot wait for episode 8. Like, you man got anything else on this episode you want to touch on?
That's everything, you know.
Nah, no one really cares about Billy's dad's issues.
Oh, but do you know what? Yeah, I want to say one thing for the record. Starlight's mum is a I just want to, like, just so if you've watched 2 seasons and we've never touched on the character, because she's a minor character, but I just wanted to put that out there, innit? And put that out there now so it's on the record, so for the rest of the universe, everyone knows where I stood in that scenario.
I feel when you should have said it, you should have emphasised it.
Bruv, the thing is, because we've never spoke about her,
yeah, I'm saying,
I don't even need to, it's not that deep, it's just that she's that, I'm not going to say it 2 times for her, she's that, we're going to move on, fam.
Now, oh, the last shot of Billy, when after all the heads get blown off, and he's just there like smirking, like, he's got this look in his face, this smirk, like he knows something.
Could be Lenny, bro, could be his brother, fam.
This one, bro.
Because he's like, talking about Lenny.
Like, he's clocked on stuff. He's like, yo, I've seen these powers before, so I know who this person is.
Mm.
And the look on his face, I really think is his brother.
It might be.
Oh, oh, so you are like, because think about it, why would you give us that whole scene of your dad?
Mm. Even before that, bro. Yeah. That, even the episode before, when they're bringing up Lenny, like, it's like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so, like, that last shot, sign is then, it's definitely connected with the heads being blown off and everything they've been given, like, with his past, his dad, and all of that.
See, and this is the thing I'm going to say, that. For me, this has got to roll into season three, fam. Because if all of this stuff just gets happened in one episode, I'm going to be like, nah, bruv. So hopefully, like, some of these storylines, half of these storylines are getting pushed into next season. But I guess all I want to, and I kind of need Stormfront dealt with next episode.
Really?
But the thing is, bruv, she's not even done enough.
Exactly.
So what we do, so what's the what happens in the finale? Nothing.
Nah, we find out maybe who's behind all this madness.
You're talking about a cliffhanger, bruv.
We had a cliffhanger in the last one. Fam just got dropped on the doorstep with the sun. That was a madness, bro.
That wasn't a cliffhanger though, bruv, because we knew what scenario. We knew what happened. The villain got beat. The villain got beat. The chick's head got blown up. Mm. She was the big bad. Homelander. We find out where Billy's wife's alive. Mm-hmm. We find out she's got a U, and we know Homelander's the dad. There's no cliffhanger there, bro.
So Barry,
we just want to know what happens next.
Yeah,
that's a good season finale,
exactly,
right?
So,
but this, you're talking about a cliffhanger.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, I don't know. I think maybe we have, I don't know, Los Pollos stepping in, I don't know, in some next suit. Like, do you know what I'm saying? Like, he's just like, next season.
We ain't even got to the bottom of, like, what happened with Stormfront and the Liberty thing. Why she's gonna win?
There's too much to just wrap up in one thing.
Yeah,
so.
but something's got to conclude in the next episode, fam.
I'm gonna say Los Boyos.
How can Los Boyos get finished?
Not finished. Step into the scene in the suit, and then that's it. Curtains. Next season.
What do you mean, Liberty and?
Obviously, she used to be Liberty. Yeah, but why? The gap. Where did you go?
Oh, right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, all of that stuff, bro. I want.
Oh, yeah, she went because obviously she did that madness with that guy, innit?
Yeah, but.
So they had to, like.
No, but, bro.
Yeah, but that's way back then, bro. No one's going to care about killing a black person.
Not even that. That happened, yeah. Mm. But they never explicitly said, we put her in a back burner. We came up with that.
Right.
Do you know what I'm saying? I want to know. Right. Do you know what I'm saying? All of that, bruv. Like, yeah, you've been around for a bit. So what's happened in that 50-year gap?
Mm-hmm.
What was you doing? Do you get what I'm saying? Anything on the church? The church moving mad. Black born in Black Arrow.
Yeah, yeah.
He's black. I've upgraded it to Black Arrow, fam.
Black Arrow. That was mad.
Each person have their own agendas, innit?
See, but don't you think it's mad how the church brother came in and was like, oh, you, man, we're close to getting you back in the 7. Oh, you see that brother over there? X him out. Him telling them that he's getting them back in the 7 is lies, channels, bruv, propaganda.
Yeah, like, so obviously it's like to make room for crackhead, isn't
it? Mm-hmm. I don't think that's what it is, bruv. He said that he spoke out.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I'm saying? Like, they told him to cut ties with his mum or something, and he said he wouldn't do it, and then they blackballed him, bruv. Something deep is going on there, bruv. He knows something, fam. He knows something. But yeah, we got to get to the bottom of that as well, bruv.
Yeah, see, that's not going to happen in the episode.
So then I'm just going to be...
Too many things,
and bruv. This is what I'm saying, bruv. Eight episodes ain't enough.
Just focus on one thing, and that's what we're going to be for next episode. Unless you're giving us a movie, bruv, they're just wrapping one thing up, and that's it. And
then one thing do you think it's going to be? They'll take predictions, innit?
I already said my one. Things reveals himself as a
super.
Yeah.
Los Boyos.
Yeah.
That's wild. Go on, what you got?
There's way too much. What's going to wrap up? I just think we're going to find out who has been behind the scenes with this blown up head thing, innit?
Oh, another thing is, Ute's mom's going to run back to Billy. Billy's taking her back.
But what? That's not even a prediction.
That's not a prediction.
That's a guarantee,
saying,
fam.
Yeah, no, I'm just
where
saying,
is she going to go?
Where
what's
Billy
he gonna
do?
No, Billy's got no other. Bro, Billy should be dead anyway, firstly. Like, bro, hey, his mission's been completed.
Mm-hmm.
And he found wifey, yeah, she's not coming back. He should have been the one setting himself on fire, bro, instead of lamplighter, fam. So, yeah, they've set him up for him and his girl to get back together, but, bro, like, don't talk to me about Billy, bro. It's done out. My prediction. I don't know. I don't want to say. Do you know what word came into my head? Disappointment. But I just don't. I don't want to say it because the boys doesn't do that, fam. So I don't know. I feel like I'm just gonna go with it. I think Stormfront might not make it out the next episode, innit? I feel like it'll be rushed, but maybe it won't be rushed, fam. Maybe, you know what I'm saying? Maybe it'll be like they if they only focus on that for an hour.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It would make sense. Yeah. Get me? So
they tend to do that, especially like with a black. What's his face?
Noir.
Yeah, when that episode's with him, they focus quite a bit on him. Then boom, he's gone the next episode. So I guess they'll focus on something like you're saying.
Yeah, man. Let's get this racist out of here, fam. I want her gone, bro. I want her gone. Anyway, guys, jump in the comment section below. It's mad. Listen, firstly, thank you to the boys. Thank you guys for releasing this week to week to week. Please, season 3, continue this energy. Ignore them online who don't know what they're talking about, yeah? Week to week, it makes this a thing. And I love that we're going to be going into the final episode. Like, man can actually watch the final episode, like, at midnight when it drops. So it's going to be mad. Anyway, guys, jump in the comment section below. There's no one who's out there with spoilers in it, so go crazy, innit? Let us know your predictions for episode 8, where you think we're going in season 3 and all of them things there. Now, before you leave, make sure if you haven't already hit the subscribe button, go over to patreon.com/thecybernerds where we will continue the boys' conversation. If you request some The Boys mashup trailers. Like, I'm giving you the advice. Like, The Boys trailer with like Man of Steel music might be a madness. Anyway, I'm Joe One Further the Cybernerds.
Raven the GS.
I'm Mr. Blitzter.
And we'll see you on the next review. Peace.